2015, something very strange happened in the Twitter sphere. It all started in a class called Buyer's Behavior with a professor named Mark. One group. One team. Came together under immense pressure to build a guerrilla marketing campaign that college students would talk about for ages to come. This group was known as the Apple Group! April 26th, Apple Group collaborated together, their brains, their bronze, and their outlandish ideas to discover untouched advertising soil. We put together an advertising campaign for the product EOS. This is where we personified our product and posted on Facebook confession pages, posing as anonymous students. Then, just when the students are starting to comment on the post, we revealed that we are EOS. It's funny. Wait, stop that. We revealed our EOS identity with clever phrases and referred viewers to our EOS Confession Twitter page. On our EOS Twitter sphere, we would ask viewers to tell us about their own lip balm stories.
Our guerrilla marketing campaign targeted the reference group of college students. They're part of a formal reference group because they're all part of a college or university. And our EOS campaign also used online and offline synergy. The online synergy was the content of the confession, and the offline was the comments that we got from the students on the page. There were multiple interpersonal influences within our campaign.
There we go. Ready?
Should I start from the beginning? Multiple interpersonal influences were found throughout our campaign. There were informational influences because the students would use the attitudes and opinions from the reference group to form their own comments. There were also value expressive influences because students joined the confession conversation to share their own experiences and opinions as well. And then there were also utilitarian influences because students would conform to the opinions of others to remain a part of the conversation and to not become an outcast within the group.
The campaign also hit three areas within the ADA model. We gained the audience's attention by creating unique stories and confession, which then piqued the interest of the students, and the call to action was also attained through the spurring conversation between the students. All right, our guerrilla marketing campaign was both interactive and non-interactive. Interactive in the sense that it targeted a smaller audience, which encouraged student feedback, but it was also non-interactive because it was inexpensive and we used creative advertising to raise awareness. But collectively, it was an example of amplified word of mouth because it spread the content about EOS and not the students.
So our campaign relied heavily on group influence because the EOS confession encouraged students to share their own opinions, beliefs, and perceptions. These comments influenced other page members to join the conversation and expand on previous comments while adding their own opinions to the conversation. We also used user-generated content by utilizing Twitter and Facebook to reach a wider range of individuals. These replies we got on Twitter and Facebook were examples of user-generated content.
We started out making a Facebook page as the EOS product.
Then we began brainstorming college confession pages that we could reach.
Together we came up with the material for each confessions post.
Lastly, we commented on our post, revealing our identity and encouraging action to follow our product on Twitter and share their own lip balm stories.
One, two.
There you go.
And here's some examples of our work.